stages. Montenegro, two wins, two defeats and a draw. Just saw them scrape through fourth place in Group A. But they are there, that's the main thing. They just need to perform on the day. Anything can happen in the knockout phase. And this is the quarterfinal. I'm going to hand you over now to the hall announcers to introduce you to the players.
Introducing France, starting with team captain, number 10, the Sophie Elbrecht. Number 3, Blandine Doncet. Number 4, Nina Camtou Njetam. Number 5, Camille Aiglon. Number 7, Alison Pinon. Number 8, Claudine Mendy. Number 9, Paula Baudouin. Number 12, Amandine Lenou. Number 16, Cleopat Delou. Number 17, Sihaba Dibele. Number 18, Audrey Dewan. Number 20, Rafael Tebel. Number 24, Miriama Signate. And number 64, Alexander Lacabert. The officials for France, Olivier Coumoltz.
So that's the team, and there is Olivier Coumoltz, the coach of the French team. Into silver in the last two World Championships. Now let's meet Montenegro. So that's the team, and this is Dragan Adzic, coach of the Montenegran team. Also coaches their champion club, Budućnost, who won the Champions League this season. The experienced pairing of Olesen and Pedersen from Denmark, who refereed the men's Euro 2010 semi-final between France and Iceland, and the 2009 men's World Championships, France-Croatia. These are the IHF officials. He will oversee the match here today. So quarter-final, two steps away from an Olympic final. But no margin for error anymore. These are not the group stages. It's the winner takes it all. And the teams line up for the final formalities before they throw off in this superb atmosphere in the Copper Box, which has been packed for every single session from the beginning and has created a superb atmosphere. So Dragan Adzic, let's have a look though at France first, and left winger Dembele, number 17, with 19 goals, a 79% success rate, has been hugely impressive so far. She should start with Doncet on the right wing. Playmaker Pinot, she's had a quiet performance by her standards so far, but should start with Aiglon right back, and either Mendy or Signate on the other side. But that is unless Mendy starts on the line, where she has been a backup player, alternated with Camtou Djitam as a makeshift line player. And goalkeeper Darleux is the second best in the tournament with 41% save rate, but Krumholtz there in the picture tends to prefer to start with the other goalkeeper, Amandine Lenoir, who is more experienced. So Krumholtz hoping to take his team to yet another semi-final in a major event. Well, Montenegro rely heavily on the Champions League winners Budućnost. 12 of their players come from that club. Handball legend Popovic, the number 17 at left back, is the fourth top scorer in the tournament with 29 goals, and she lines up alongside Katarina Bulatovic with 28 goals, and they provide a formidable threat at the back. On the wing, Savic and Miljanic have been on good form, while line player Djokic has scored 8 from 10 goals, a good ratio. Both goalkeepers, Vukcevic and Barjak Taurovic, are on a 31% save rate. So Dragan Adzic, first outing for the Montenegrin team at an Olympic tournament under their own flag. There is Alisson Pino, World Player of the Year in 2009. 11 goals so far in the competition, but a 39% success rate. It could be higher. And there the legend, Bojana Popovic, who will retire after the Olympics, who plays for Budućnost, 32 years of age. He's scored 29 so far. But for Montenegro, 279 goals scored in just 51 appearances. It is quite a phenomenal record for Popovic. But they will have an equal threat on the other side at right back with Katarina Bulatovic as the officials shake hands ahead of the game. They know each other well. Played each other in the Olympic Games qualifying tournament recently, when ironically it was played in Lyon in France, but it was Montenegro who beat France 22-20. Both teams still went through to the Olympics, obviously. They're here again. So here we go. Lars Ebu Pedersen blows the whistle and the quarterfinal gets underway. Montenegro in the white strip playing from left to right, throw off. France in the all blue strip open up with a 6-0 defense. They'll have to be very mindful of number 32, Katarina Bulatovic, and Popovic 17, who ambles in from the other side. She really makes things happen, and the French defense give her an early present by just parting and letting her walk straight through. Couldn't have been easier if she tried. Collision early on. Susanna Lazovic brings Signati to a grinding halt. So these two teams met 2 months ago in the Olympic qualifying tournament in Lyon in France. Montenegro beating France 22-20. Knežević got 7 on that occasion. And the response from France. Dembele. She's been hugely impressive and puts the ball beyond the outreached arms of Sonja Barjaktarović. Both goalkeepers play for Budućnost. 12 of the club, in fact, 12 of the players rather, play for Budućnost, who won the Champions League and the Montenegrin League. Bulatovic tees up Popovic. There's a big gap down the middle. Fantastic save by Amandine Leno. The ball is picked up by Mendy. And Pino, what a shot. In her stride, just lets rip with a low shot straight through the keeper. Look at this. Runs to one side, but puts the ball completely to the other side, and Leno celebrates down the far end. Quite remarkable for Pino, who tore her cruciate ligaments in the semi-final against Denmark at the World Championships back in December last year in Brazil. Missed the final. She's been out for most of the season since. There was a real angst for Kumholz about whether he should pick her with so little match practice, but she started slowly, but has hit form as the tournament's gone on. And penalty given for the foul on Lazovic. Defending inside the area by Dembele. Bulatovic. No problem there. And she stands in front of the goalkeeper, roaring on at her. Pino looks for the line. And that's going to be a yellow card for Katarina Bulatovic. Grabs Mendy, who's normally a left back, but it's being used as a makeshift line player here. She's a tall player, 1.82 meters. Come to Gitan, the only line player they've taken with them, France, 1.78, and they may need something a little bit bigger against this big Montenegrin defence. Lovely goal by Marijama Signate. The 27-year-old who plays for IC Paris. Dummies the pass, look at that. Both players duck out of the way, and then she goes through the open gap, 3-2 to France early on here. So slow build up. Knezević goes good. Pass into the line and another yellow card. This time for Signate. And here is White. Free throw going to be taken, and Knezević thinks about it, but instead puts it across to Popović. Well, if you let her get in that close, of course you'll score. Popović, who together with the captain Savic, number 14, have both announced that they are retiring from professional handball after these Olympics, and they will be hoping to go out on a high with an Olympic medal. What a dream that would be. Pino, this time it sails wide. Knezević saved. We've got a 2-minute suspension for Signate. She was already on a yellow card. First 2-minute suspension of the day. Lars Abu Pedersen. Very quick on the whistle for the little shove. Penalty's been given. Bulatović again. And she scores again. Second penalty for her. She stays in front of goal. Look at this. Every time she scores, a challenge to the goalkeeper. 27-year-old who plays for Buducnost, but is moving on to Olkin Vulcea in Romania, where ironically she will be with Alison Pino, who's also moving there from Metz. So two opponents today, soon to be teammates. Oh, that was lucky. Lacrabert puts it back in towards the middle. Pino. Straight through, Eglon. And past the 5-minute mark, it's 4-4. Camille Eglon, he plays for Nîmes. Katarina Bulatović. Here she comes. Oh, fantastic play. Drops the ball over the top of the defence into Lazović, 20-year-old line player. Two players go up, but there's no one covering the line. No chance for the keeper, especially she stood back, didn't come out to cut the angle. Free throw. A foul on Camille Yiglon. And France finished sixth in 2000 and 2008. In 2004, they got through to the bronze medal playoff but lost to the Ukraine. And that's an attacking foul by Pino, who crashes right through Lazović. Back come Montenegro. Popović trying to clear the ball. Pino knocks the ball away from Knezević. It buys time for the French defence to get back in order. It was clever play. The defender took a step back, just one, and then stood her ground there. And it meant that Pino, who was expecting a contact to kind of work off, didn't have it. Instead, she fell into her. Knezević, Popović. Popović thinks about the shot, but she's locked immediately. Good defending by Lacrabert, who's come on, the 25-year-old. Plays for the champions, Arvor Brest. Katarina Bulatović goes sailing over the top. And it's a foul by Radicevic. Gets a yellow card, but she smiles. She spoiled the fast break. That was the main aim of the foul. Grabs her around the collar. Probably lucky to stay on in some respects. In fact, it was Dembele she pulled over. So Doncet comes out and goes back in on the line, trying to feed the ball through to the line, but it's a free throw. Still only one goal in it, just after the 8th minute of the game. No way through for Pino, who's... well, not enough time for Dembele to control the ball. The pass to her above the area too low, and Barjaktarović makes a comfortable save. Katarina Bulatovic in the bottom of the picture, number 32, teeing herself up. She's got amazing scoring. 104 goals for Montenegro in just 19 games. Bulatovic. Pino. Penalty. Pino passes to Iglon as she drives through. She's fouled. She's coming in now, and there's the push. And well, it's exactly the same that Signati got a 2-minute suspension for a little earlier, but a little leniency shown for the legend. And so steps up Paul Boudouin. And she scores. 27-year-old plays for Le Havre, although she's moving to Metz, and Adzic looks on as France level it. It's 5-5. No luck for Barjaktarović, the 25-year-old. And although Montenegro won the last encounter between these two teams back in May at Euro 2010, the only other time these two teams met, France won it 23-19, so it's honours even at the moment. Both these teams then qualifying, despite Montenegro's win over France, in a group that also featured Romania and Japan, who didn't go through. And Bulatovic scores again, adds to her impressive tally with those 104 goals in just 19 internationals. Perfectly placed right up in the corner, and they lead again. Pino gets a free throw. 11 minutes played in the first half. Signati, Dembele. That's more like it. Signati, who's not had a huge success with her shooting, 11 goals but only a 34% success rate. Scored 5 in her opener against Norway, but went a little bit quiet after that. This is more what we're used to seeing from Signati, who plays for Issy Paris. She, like Pino, missed the final at the World Championships last year in Brazil when she got a fractured eye socket after a training accident when she collided with her teammate Eglon. Katarina Bulatovic switches back. Popovic straight through. And they're just teasing the center of the defense at the moment, overloading it. And Krumholz looks on disconsolately. Where was the defense? They closed the door too late. And once more, Montenegro are leading 7-6. They've lost possession. Seven goals from only 9 attempts for Montenegro so far, 78% success rate. France 6 from 8 shots, 75%, so not taking a lot of shots, but when they are, they're making sure they're accurate. Knizhevich in the center. Popovic went in but didn't get the ball straight away, switches back to Bulatovic. Knizhevich blocked by Tervel, the veteran of the French team, the 33-year-old who's played 230 internationals, scoring 357 goals for France. These days used extensively in defense, but occasionally in attack when steady hands needed. She plays for Ijaco in Spain. Although that club now bankrupt, will need to change. Saved by Amandine Leno, 26-year-old goalkeeper. From Metz, he's moving to Alkin Vulca, and an unforced error. Too many steps by Iglon. What was she thinking? Totally unforced. Thank you. It's Pinot, in fact, that's Epps going out of gear, I guess. Basic mistake. Popovic into the line. Goes straight through, though. It's going to be a corner throw. They came off a defender. Lino couldn't get to it fast enough to get the last touch before he crossed the line. It's in handball if the ball comes off the goalkeeper and goes over the back line. Inside, when she's inside her area, then it's a goalkeeper throw. The ball travelling too fast, really, for goalkeepers to be expected to carry. That won't count. She was inside the area. Bulatovic went in too far. Attacking foul, and that's well played. It's Andjela Bulatovic, no relation to Katarina, who stood her ground, waited for the collision. And Pino absolutely felled by Popovic. She drove straight through her. And Andjela Bulatovic, the 25-year-old, as Krumholz gives his verdict on that one. They're charging through. Now that looked like she crashed straight into Eglon at the back, sent her flying. She rolls off the first one, Tervel, that's good. But there, 6 of 1 half dozen of the other. But the ball's given to Montenegro. Clock has been stopped. In handball, the clock rarely stopped as Knezevic received treatment on a knee, taking a knock in the process. Popovic fumbles the ball. Katarina Bulatovic is there to pick it up. Popovic looks for the line. The line is blocked, but held, say the referees, and it's another free throw. Montenegro. Stolen by Signate. Eglon, quick long pass down. Dansette looks for support. Signate, what was she doing? I'm not sure, she must have lost control of the ball as she grabbed it. It's the second time in the game now she's had a handling error under no pressure. And we passed the midway point in the first half. And Montenegro are leading France 7-6. Five turnovers already for France, three for Montenegro. Long-range shot, clatters off the crossbar. Lino puts it up. This time Signate is a little bit more careful. Pino, Signate. She's got choices on the line, but Bulatovic stops her from passing. And three French players go off. The ball is not played yet. So into the frame comes Kamto Gitam on the line. A change then from Mendy. Well, at right back they've got Lacrabert. Mendy instead has gone into the left-back position. Try to inject a bit of pace into this attack as the chance of Aleli Bleu resound around the copper box. Lacrabert. Mendy brought down. French number 8, who, as it happens, is moving to Budućnost next season, the Montenegrin champions. So she's up against 12 of her soon-to-be teammates. And she gives them a bit of demonstration of the kind of power that they've just bought. Nice long-range effort from Mendy. Shoots low and takes Barjaktarović by surprise. All in the wrist. And Lino can celebrate down the far end. French keeper. 7-all. It's low, low scoring. Ah, walk in the park, but Lino saves the day. But the French defence is certainly not cohesive early on here. Mendy puts it out to Pino, Lacrabert. Tervel has gone into the back, but eventually goes off. She'll change with Kamto Gitam, the line player. He plays for Metz. Metz, who surprisingly lost the French championship this year to Arvor Brest in the final playoff. Shot by Lacrabert is saved by Barjaktarović. Lacrabert, who's scored 10, but with only a 37% success rate, which is not great. Popovic into the line. Oh, fantastic, but stolen. Pino. Oh, what a pass. A fantastic goal. And that's exactly the trademark of the French team. steal the ball and go out quick. It was a sublime pass down the court by Pino, weaved through the eye of a needle between two defenders, and Dembele drops it underneath Barayek Tarovic. And for the first time in the game, France have the lead. Line, no one called her, and Mendy sitting too far off the line. Djokic, 33-year-old, Serbian-born, scores. She's not been with the team that long, although she is a regular at Budućnost, 18 caps and 50 goals, Djokic. She's leveled the score meanwhile here. Looks for the line, no way through for Kamto Gitan, but she's held up by Lazovic and gets a free throw. Mendy, Pino, Lacrabert, Mendy through, attacking foul, the defense closed quickly enough. Good play by Radicevic and Djokic to close the door on her. So it left back for, or into the center rather, goes Jovanovic, number 8, plays for Olkim Vulca in Romania. Used to be the Budućnost captain until she moved off to Romania. Here she comes. Popovic, Katarina Bulatovic, good save. Fourth save of the game for Amandine Leno. And no luck for Mendy on the break, and back come Montenegro very quickly. Jovanovic puts the ball in and comes out again. Popovic back again into the wing. Lovely play. They switch the play left again. And Maja Savic scores her first of the game, the captain. Team timeout. Just bear in mind that with 12 of the players, their starting lineup, coming from Budućnost, the same club, they train together day in, day out. And the coach of the Montenegro team, Adzic, is also coach of Budućnost. And that goal by Savic. He's on 11 goals so far in the competition, gives them the lead back again. Adzic, as ever, calm, goes for exactly what he wants. But these are players he knows very, very well indeed. Very few are not in Budućnost. Radicevic is at Giurietto in Hungary. Jovanovic, we mentioned, Olkin Vulca in Romania. And that's it. The rest of the squad are all the Budućnost club who won the Champions League. And it's the kind of together time that other teams just don't have. And that's why they're seen as a real podium potential, Montenegro. So top scoring at the moment is Katarina Bulatovic and Bojana Popovic, the two big threats at the back with 3 goals apiece. Bulatovic, 2 of hers coming though from the 7-meter line. So Lacrabert is now in the center, Iglond right back and Signati at left back. Dembele comes out to help as the Montenegro defense push in. And Kamto Gitan lets rip with a very quick arm. 7 French players have scored the 9 goals so far as we go past the 20-minute mark. Lovely pass into her, and Kamto Gitan puts it on the inside post. Gives a thumbs up for the pass into her by Signati. Ball stolen just ahead of Dembele, who scores, and Signati. Dembele, 3rd goal. But look at Signati there, the perfect pass. Bulatovic, 1.86 meters. She's a big player. She had to lob it high and ahead of her, and Dembele had to run onto it. And France sneak back in front again. This game just seesawing one way then the other. But we knew it probably would, since these two teams were so close in that playoff for the Olympics in France. Bulatovic, Popovic, Katarina Bulatovic runs into the defender. It's an attacking foul. Dembele's away again. And a good save by Barjaktarovic. Oh, they've lost the ball and Montenegro. Signate comes up. Puts it wide. Barjaktarovic not troubled by that one. First miss of the game for Signatic. She scored 2 from 3. End-to-end stuff here in this quarter-final. It's packed arena, 7,000-seater. Has been a wonderful setting for the competition. Was that an attacking foul? Into the line, penalty. It's a close contact to play here, and Krumholz called out as the left back drove in. That was the drive-in before that one. So Bulatovic scores again, a third penalty. Fourth goal in total, and it's all square again. Lacabert switches back again. Long range shot by Camille Yiglon, the 27-year-old from Nîmes. Takes off, and the Kamto Gitam holding back two defenders to give her a free shot down the middle, and Yiglon adds to a tally of 287 goals for France in 128 internationals. She's played in 3 world championships. Very experienced, Yiglon. Wing, brilliant play. Popovic with the pass, and the passion in the players is amazing. Radicevic, the scorer, but clever play by Popovic. Look at this, he sees that the whole defense is pulled over, and Paul Boudouin, who'd strayed out, pays the price. Play on, say the referees. That was a good call by them. Into the wing, not much going on there. Lacabert comes in again. Signate, and a low shot by Signate. Her third of the game. Low and around the defense. Right in the far post. So goal 3 for Signate, and Montenegro changing the goalkeeper. Barjaktarovic is coming out, and Vukcevic is going in. Tries to look on the line. The ball is stolen. Almost too high. Boudouin scores despite a little push in the back. Kept the composure, the 27-year-old from Le Havre. There she is. There's a little shove on the way past. If anything, it propelled her above the area. Nice play by Boudouin. He goes to Metz next season after scoring 95 goals in the French league this year for Le Havre. France lead by 2. Popovic, and a yellow card for Yiglon, France number 5. They'll come back for a free throw for Montenegro. 4 minutes remaining. Oh, the goalkeeper just lifted a leg, and it was enough space for Radicevic to score. Reaction on the bench. Saved. Comes in and makes a great save. Marina Vukcevic. Nizivic races down. And back on comes Bulatovic, and oh, charge right in front of goal. Djokic would normally score those in a carpet slippers, and she puts it on the outside of the post. Once again, Popovic the provider. She's just such a key element of the team into the last 3 minutes. Tries to go through Siniatin, no way there. Signati tries to go around, gets tripped by Lazovic. You see the heavy braces on both knees. She's had fair problems, Mariama Signati. Wants the floor mopped, a little concerned about her. And she's gone down. Play on, says the referee, Djokic. And she's really found the range, Radicevic. She scores at a 2 minute suspension for Kamto Gitan. Vukcevic at the other end cheers as they've made up the 2 goal deficit. It's all square, but also they have a power play now for the remainder of the first half. Kamto Gitan sent off for 2 minutes for an earlier push. Signati puts it wide. She's becoming a little bit expensive with her shooting. Back on comes Katarina Bulatovic, not being used in defense at the moment, the number 32. And Sonia Barniak-Tarovic on the bench. Stands for that Vukcevic save, and a team timeout's been called by Montenegro. Dragan Adzic trying to make sure that his team fully capitalized on this opportunity to go into the halftime break with a lead. 1 minute and 14 seconds remaining from the first half. France have taken a 13-11 lead and let it slip. Popovic always keen to have a word in these huddles, and Adzic goes, yes, but let me have my word first. Such an amazing array of talent. What a generation of players they have, Montenegro, all coming together at this time. You've got the likes of Popovic and Savic, hugely experienced. And then you have the new young players, the Knizovic of this world, and Mimidovic and Miljanic. Really do have a bright future. Amandine Leno, who's not had a stunning first half so far. 4 saves for 24% save rate. And we're coming up to the last minute with the power play for Montenegro. And she just managed, Tervel, to take the ball from under the nose of Djokic, but stay outside the area. Did incredibly well, and that's bought time for France while they're shorthanded. And the crowd are cheering Olivier Bleu. They'll try and test the referees and see how long they're prepared to give them in these closing stages of the first half. 30 seconds to go before the halftime break. And Katarina Bulatovic with a totally unnecessary push, but at neck height on Iglon, gets sent off, and that levels things up. Temptation too much. Her right hand around the neck. And the players know this, it's amazing, they still do it. You've got to try and go for shoulders, but that's what they'll say they were doing. It's just that they misjudged it slightly, or the player moved. Both teams short-handed. Bit of an angle, Dansette, saved by the keeper, and a great start and goal for Vukcevic, the 18-year-old, and Adzic delighted. 7 seconds, a chance here. What can Popovic pull out of the bag? She can't. Clips the post, goes out. And there is the buzzer. It's all square at the break. Bulatovic top scoring with 4 goals, 3 of them penalties, but Popovic and Radicevic have 3 apiece for Montenegro. While for France, the top scorers are Dembele and Signate. 3 apiece for them as well. But France will start the second half with just a few seconds before they're back to full strength and then have a minute and a half of a power play. Intriguing first half. 72% success rate on the shooting for France, 67 for Montenegro, which is quite high for both teams. They've been quite economical with their shooting in this quarterfinal. So at the halftime break then, it's all square here between France and Montenegro, 13 all. Well, it just goes to show 13 goals from 22 attempts for both teams, exactly the same statistics in fact, but in the case of France, they have failed to score from the only 2 wing shots they've had, but they're not getting the ball out there enough. 2 wing shots in a one half is very low. Admittedly, neither went in. 2 from 9 meters though for Montenegro. Could be better. Their long range shooting not so good. France compare favorably there with 7 goals from 12 from the long range shooting at 9 meters. That's from where the dotted line is effectively on the court as you look at it. So here are the highlights of the first half. So those are the highlights. Let's now look at the statistics from the first half. They're exactly the same goal scoring average, 13 goals from 22 for both teams. Fast breaks, France getting three fast breaks, missing one on the way, while Montenegro haven't been able to capitalize yet, although they have had phase two attacks. 8-7 turnovers, fairly equal. Three penalties to Montenegro, one to France, and those two suspensions, 2 minute suspensions for the French team, one for Montenegro. Goalkeeping wise, Amandine Leno, five saves for France, 28%. That's low. I wonder if we'll see Cléopâtre Darleux in the second half. While Barjaktarović made three saves, 20%, that's even lower. But Vukcevic, who's come in for her, has already made three saves from four shots and is doing very well indeed, and will doubtless continue in the second half. That's how it stands then in this quarterfinal between the world vice champions France and Montenegro. We'll take a short break, but join us again in just a few moments for the second half. We'll see you then. Welcome back to the Copper Box, then half-time in this quarter-final in the Women's Olympic Handball Competition. France and Montenegro, 13 apiece. They cannot be separated. And Adzic, well, what has he come up with in the half-time break for France? Well, they've both defended very, very well, but France, for their part, well, their main problem at the moment is not much wing play, not spreading it wide enough, but then again, the defence is working well. There is Darleux, the other goalkeeper with the distinctive glasses. I thought she might start the second half, but it looks, at the moment at least, as if Lenoir might be the one going in. So for Montenegro, four goals from Katarina Bulatovic, three of them penalties, and three from Popovic and the right winger Radicevic. Number four in the picture there, plays for Giurietto in Hungary. Put them in good posture, each team hitting with two goals, getting ahead, and then the other one would come back and hit two goals. And it continued to go backwards and forwards. And there is Vukcevic, who replaced Barjaktarovic, and has played very well indeed since coming in. Three saves from four shots. So here we go then, the second half. France throw off and are immediately back to full strength again. The suspension served out and now have a power play situation for the next 2 minutes. And again, Signati proving to be incredibly wasteful, scored from her opening two goals and two shots rather, and has since then only scored one from five. Gives the opportunity now for Montenegro to make this a long attack, hopefully. France defend very deep, almost a 1-5, one at the back, five pushing up. That's fine as long as no one goes in behind, but someone will. Here they go. Popovic well marked as Lazovic drives in behind to try and take the defense back. She will head back the other way. She is a line player by definition, but is at the moment starting on the right wing. Then here she comes again, trying to dart in behind. Popovic. Hard shot by Jovanovic, but parried away by Amandine Lenoir, who stays in goal at the beginning of the second half, despite only a 28% save rate. And Aiglon gets a free throw. She goes straight off. Pinot, rather, gets a free throw. Aiglon goes off. Pinot being told to stay on as they make a few changes at the back. And Signati, who's been expensive with her shooting, is being changed over now. Lacrabert goes into the center and pushes Pinot wide on the left, and Aiglon is back. Well, she's got a range. Pinot, her second of the game. And she's happy. World Player of the Year in 2009. Just recovered from her ruptured cruciate ligaments. Katarina Bulatovic. Signati staying in defense though. She's a good strong defender in that respect. There she is again on Katarina Bulatovic. They've stolen the ball. Pinot is away. Feeds out to Dembele. It won't count. She was inside the area when the ball left her hand. And it's a free throw. And Knezevic arms aloft. She got what she wanted. She crashes into the French player, knowing full well that she's going to give away the free throw. She falls for effect, really, for the referee. And the crowd don't like it. They felt that should have been a penalty. Lacrabert. Dembele, it has to come back out again. They're getting bogged down in the wing. That's not going to help them at all. Aiglon, good defending by Djokic. Holds up Aiglon. Both teams at full strength now. Long range shot. That's more like it. Lacrabert, number 64. He plays for Havre Brest, who's top scorer in the French National League with 125 this season. It's a lot of goals. And Vukcevic unable to stop any further shots so far here in this next half. Ball stolen by Dembele. She manages to release it quickly to Pino to keep their flow going. Doncet held very high. They've got to come back. Doncet trying to cut back towards the middle, and the pass really shot out of her hand when she got pulled backwards. And so France settle at the back. 4 minutes played. And they've taken a two-goal lead, but this has happened before, and each time Montenegro have struck back. Pino looks for the line, but it's intercepted. Knizovic puts it out quickly. Bulatovic, Popovic. Free throw's been given. And on in defense comes Signati and Tervel quickly. Ball goes across. Lacrabert. Bit of a shove in the air. And Lazovic comes back. Well, their confidence is high, Montenegro, coming into these Olympics. It's a team who've won their own national league, they've won the Champions League, they qualified for the Olympics. Top of a group in France, beating the French on their own doorstep. Although both teams did go through, Radicevic gets her fourth goal. She scored 4 from 4, 100% record for the Montenegrin right winger. Lacrabert. Signati tries to release Eglon. Puts it through the goalkeeper's legs under a lot of pressure. That's very nicely taken by the 27-year-old. Turns around. Knizovic lets her go, thinking that the angle is going to be awkward. But it goes through the legs of the keeper, and France have the two-goal lead again, and we're coming up to 6 minutes played. Popovic, Knizovic. Ball stolen unfairly, say the referees, and they'll come back for a free throw. Lucky break for Montenegro there, the shot blocked by the French wall. Knizovic, nothing, say the referees. Lino looks for a quick pass down the court, but the wingers are too closely marked. Signati, Tervel. They'll come back again. It's end-to-end stuff here. Mistakes at both ends. Knizovic, Popovic. Penalty given. Signati thought she had the ball, but it was ripped out of Popovic's hands. There it is. And that had to be a penalty, really. And it'll be taken once more by Katarina Bulatovic as we see the incident again. She's holding the hand. If she knocked the ball clean out of the hand, might have been something different. Krumholz yelling from the side. So, Katarina Bulatovic again. And she fails, hits the crossbar, and it goes out of play. She looks to the referee and says it touched the goalkeeper's fingers, which if it had, of course, would make it a throw into Montenegro. Let's have a look. She did. Katarina Bulatovic has a point. The French goalkeeper did tip it onto the post. The referees didn't see that, though. They thought it had just been a straight hit. Dembele, Signati. She's breaking up the flow at the moment, Signati. She goes for the shot every time. She's missed out this time. Lacrabert blocked off the defense, picked up by Djokic, and a breakout by Montenegro. Savic down the left wing. Andjela Bulatovic. He'll go off. She's been used in defense only at the moment. Popovic. And now Katarina Bulatovic comes into the fray as well. Switch back. Still in play. And quite rightly, Lacabert doesn't try and push things. She's down on the ground, not got a good view of the play. And decides to slow things down. So a flurry of missed opportunities on both sides here. Lacrabert, Signaté, she's got it again. She's found her range, her fourth goal, and France edge ahead 17-14. Signaté gives the thumbs up there. Ici Paris, she plays for. Missed part of the season with that eye socket injury at the World Championships. Well, Katarina Bulatovic drives through and gets a penalty. Shove from Signaté. And it's Popovic who's going to take it now after Bulatovic missed the last one. Oh, it's saved! Fantastic save by Amandine Lenoir. She had a lackluster first half, but the second half is out of this world. Her save rate's crept up to 36. Dummies the high pass. Goes for the hard one. And disappointment for the Montenegrin veteran. Eglon. Derouin, who's come in on the right wing. Off the post. Stays with France, though. Dembele's got the loose ball. Unlucky for Eglon. Dembele, Signaté. Lacrabert off the post again. It will once more stay with France as Eglon picks up the loose ball. They are peppering the goal at the moment, but it won't go in. Metalwork seems to be taking the strain. Lacrabert, Signaté, tries to release the wing, but she's lost the ball. Popovic is away. Dembele comes across, saved, and it's a free throw and a superb intervention by Dembele. Came in and basically screened her, didn't hold her, just screened. She puts her hands up. And therefore, it's not a penalty, it's just a free throw. And we're past the 10-minute mark in the second half. France still lead 17-14. Montenegro trying to find the solutions. Jovanovic is in the centre. Katarina Bulatovic again. Penalty, can't give the goal, they say. Your foot was inside. But each time she attacks on that side, Signaté is found wanting in defence. Signaté's got to move up, force her wide, so she's got a sharp angle to turn into. Two missed penalties. Knizovic will try now. Well, coolly taken. The pressure was on after they missed two. Look at this. Ice cool, tipped her wrist back and runs it off her fingertips, and the bench cheer on as well. Two goals in it. Jokic is straying out now in defence. They're trying to unsettle the French backs. And Signaté, not a hard shot, but on this occasion, Vukcevic completely out of position. A fifth goal for the 27-year-old, who scored already 251 for France in 118 internationals. And the goalkeeper followed the body movement rather than the line of shot. And they've changed the goalkeeper now. Barjak Tarovic is back in again. Big angle for the shot. It's saved. Radicevic has been successful four times from four shots so far. Misses her first of the game. Lino, well, it was an inspired decision leaving her in the second half, Lino, after she had a lackluster first. Lacrabert, Signaté. Mendy has now come into the attack, playing it right back, but off the post, and again the woodwork taking the strain. France have been unlucky now three times in the last 5 minutes. Needed to drop it in underneath the feet. Popovic goes around. Katarina Bulatovic. They're trying to up the tempo, but Popovic is inside. Oh, fantastic pass, and another great save. And at the moment, Lino is untenable. The Montenegrins just can't find a solution against her. What a brilliant play. Well, the whole crowd are singing Amandine, Amandine, the goalkeeper's first name. Attacking foul, it's given to Montenegro. 13 minutes played, back come Montenegro quickly, Jovanovic. And sends the goalkeeper the wrong way this time, and it's a goal, the first of the game for the 26-year-old, one of the few who doesn't play. I should say one of the two, in fact, that doesn't play for Budućnost. Plays for Olkim Vulča. Although she's only just left Budućnost. Mendy goes in on the line, the number eight. Prefers being there than at right back because she is actually right-handed. Not a great shot. And the defenders rushing to get to the ball, dive inside the area. And the referee, Per Olesen, points to a French throw. Mendy, Lacrabert. It's in. A second. And France restore three-goal lead. On they come. Popovic just exchanging a few words with the referee on the way. And there is Lacrabert with a second goal. 25-year-old who plays for Arbor Brest. Into the wing. Beautifully done. Miljanic, who's just come on for Radicevic. She's scored 13 in the competition so far. 24-year-old who's played 88 times for Montenegro. Just 96 goals, not a prolific scorer. But here at this competition, she scored 13 with a 65% success rate, which is good. Two goals in it, and we've reached the midway point in the second half in this quarterfinal. Looking to the line, come to Gitan, couldn't get to it, the break is on, Popovic. She's got the ball again, straight down the middle, she won't miss. Four goals and they're closing the gap to just one. Just goes to show how quickly your fortunes change. Two quick hits, one after the other. Well, she gives absolutely everything, Bojana Popovic, the 32-year-old. She's been a five times Champions League winner with three different clubs, Slagelse, Vibor of Denmark, and Budućnost this year, of course, of Montenegro. Poor effort by Dembele this time. And the ball's still in play. So Krumholz beginning to look a bit anxious. 14 minutes remaining in the quarterfinal. Katarina Bulatovic, penalty, great play. There's so little space, she really does thread it through her. Tiny hole, look at that. The ball's thrown in at such pace and Lazovic holds it. And Kumol's I think more upset with his defense than anything else. Nezivic. Saved again. Three penalty misses. And the Montenegrin fans can't believe, they go, what's happening? Popovic, Bulatovic and Naknizevic have all seen penalties save. Let off for France, then you still lead, but just by one goal, 13 minutes remaining. Eglon, Lacrabert cuts back inside. Save, but there's a free throw. Push on Lacrabert. 25-year-old tumbles. Come to Gitam, makes the pass and will drop back inside. Lacrabert, Signate, looking to go inside. Quick pass around, Eglon into the wing. Derouin comes out and that's a 2-minute suspension. It was clumsy rather than ill-intentioned, and Savic, the 36-year-old captain, gets a 2-minute suspension. Just a momentary lapse, that's all it takes. Nezivic not being used in defense, but now has to come in. She slots in where the captain was before. And Jela Bulatovic. Inside, defending, penalty's been given. A foul being drawn here. That's where she ran through the area, that's why, and she's standing in the area when she pushes Paul Boudouin. And so back on comes Lacrabert to take the penalty. She's up against Bariaktarovic. Who saves? Both sides are being wasteful. Well, she leans one way and actually sends the ball the same way. Could prove expensive later on. France just the one goal lead. They've had up to a three goal lead at one point. Free throw. Popovic drives to the center. The defense very deep this time. They close quickly on Djokic. Free throw. Much shorter line play. 165 only, Djokic. Off her foot, Katarina Bulatovic. Aiglon quickly into Derouin. And Derouin lost her balance completely, fell in the area with the ball, missed opportunity. Popovic. Bulatovic loiters at the back, and then the ball's handed off, and Bariaktarovic. Currently the goalkeeper with six saves, 32%. That's improving all the time. Change on the line makes more sense at the moment. I have to say Lazovic has been impressive. She's a bigger player on the line. 72 kilos, holds her weight well into the wing. No way through there for Mimidovic, who's come into the fray. And a yellow card. Switch back, Popovic. Little handoff. Katarina Bulatovic tries to go through. Shoots straight into the goalkeeper. France, stream out. Signate. And she's fouled by Jovanovic, who seems to just be trying to buy time for her teammates to get organized. France used the time to make substitutions as well. The team timeout's been called by France. Well, it's close, and they haven't scored for a little while now. It's just been head to head for 5 minutes. The tension is palpable, I have to say, at the moment, as we are inside the last 10 minutes. Both coaches calm and very specific about what they want from the teams. So what can they do? It looks like Doncet is going to replace Derouin on the right wing. Derouin, who struggled a little bit in fairness, and then had that bizarre tumble when she had the ball. Top scoring then Signate with five in the game so far for France. Bulatovic and Popovic and Radicevic all on four. Pino, Aiglon, Signate. Good defending by Montenegro. Both teams have been defending well. 9 minutes remaining. Looks for the line, and Kamto Gitan appeared to be pulled over before the ball reached her. Back come Montenegro. Popovic. Knezevic goes off, as does Andjela Bulatovic. Popovic suddenly accelerates. Off the post. A let off for France. The shot by Majda Mimirovic, the 22-year-old, the winger who has replaced Savic. crowd. French supporters trying to lift the team with Allez les Bleus. Fantastic atmosphere here in the copper box and the tension really high. France lead by just the one goal. Signate. Again, excellent defending. Angela Bulatovic comes out quickly. Pino. And Kanto Jitam picks up the loose ball. The first shot was very weak. Bounced off the keeper, but Kanto Jitam. Signate there takes it. But Baryaktarovic couldn't get a composure back again in time to stop the follow-up by Kanto Jitam in France. After 6 minutes without goals. Make it a two-goal lead, but not for long. Miminovic is on range now. And the Montenegrins are cheering on as well. 7.5 minutes remaining. And Montenegro, who were tipped to be one of the teams on the podium with this amazing array of talent they have, up against France, though, hugely experienced as well. And this is proving to be an excellent game. Really, the hallmark has been great defending by both teams, fast break goals. And the ball goes out to the side, throw in for France. The success rate with the shooting as the players get tired, those dropping, is 51% for Montenegro, 53. In fact, it's the same now, 51 after that missed shot for France. Aiglon looking to get it into the line, come to Gitan. Bounced out of her hands, and Dembele, who's come on the left wing again for Boudouin, luckily for them, controls the ball, and Pino sees the gap. Gets a third goal. Kanto Jitam holding the player back. It opens the corridor, and Adzic can't believe it. Still plenty of time, though. 6 minutes remaining. It's only two goals. So much experience on the Montenegrin side. Popovic. Ball stolen. Team timeout called by Adzic for Montenegro. Well, Popovic, normally such an influence in the game, is being much better marked in the second half by France. They've closed her down. She's got one goal in this half. But their long-range shooting is letting them down. Montenegro have such firepower at the back with Katarina Bulatovic and Popovic have scored only three long-range efforts from 9 meters from 11 shots. France have scored 13. They're working on the lower percentages, though, from 25 shots. So will it be Montenegro or France to go through to the semi-finals in 2 days' time, when the handball activities move out of the copper box and move across to the basketball arena with 12,000 seats? And if it's the atmosphere, anything like we've had here every single day for every single game, it will be fabulous. 6 minutes remaining. Play resumes. Katarina Bulatovic tries to go through. Free throw. What a superb athlete she is. 19 matches played, 104 goals, Katarina Bulatovic. What a phenomenal record. Here she comes again. At least in the second half, though, France are doing their best to control her. And that's a penalty, the foul on Jovanovic. Goes around. Tervel lets go before she gets to the area, but Popovic. No mistake, brave of her to step up again after missing it earlier. That's her fifth. One goal in it again. 5 minutes remain. Signate, Lacrabert, Dembele. Gap opens up briefly. Aiglon couldn't quite exploit it. Signate, not a great pass. Lacrabert saved inside the area again by Montenegro. And Jela Bulatovic picks up the ball. She was outside the area but then fell backwards into the area with the ball. Let off for France, and the Montenegrin fans complain. No goal, say the referees. Montenegrin ball. Chance to level it here. Lizevic. Four minutes remain. Jovanovic comes on holding up her hands, calling a move. Obviously dictated by Adzic from the bench. Here comes Popovic. Looks back to her. Well, she hesitated. Jovanovic clearly catching a defender's hand on the way. Quite sure who it was, reached out to her and caught her. Play resumes. Cool nerves are needed now for both sides. It's anybody's to take here. Popovic. And she scores. They've leveled it. Sixth goal for Popovic, and Krumholz can't believe it. 21 all. Two goal lead disappears for France again. And this has been the story of the game. Swinging one way then the other. Both sets of fans cheering as loudly as they can. Signate puts it wide. 3 minutes to go. Montenegro, are they going to steal it here? Popovic. Katarina Bulatovic. She's been quiet in this second half. Shot taken, it goes wide by Jovanovic. Long pass, that was unwise. Penalty. And Dembele fouled as she went to shoot. And a 2 minute suspension as well. What a pass by Lino. It looked like she was about to give it away. Huge pass, there were two defenders there. Somehow Dembele picks it out and Miljanic, the number two, gets herself a 2 minute suspension. Adzic. Can't believe it. Miljanic is in tears on the bench. Someone needs to comfort her. It's saved by Barjaktarovic. French ball. 2 minutes and 20 seconds. It's all square. Miljanic has perked up a little now. Saved by the keeper. 40% save rate now. For Barjaktarovic. Two minutes to go. Lacrabert into the wing. Dembele saved again. Goalkeeper's ball. Well, the goalkeeper's coming good here at the end. Dembele, who was on a 79% success rate going into the game, misses what could be a costly shot from the wing. Miminovic coming in. Popovic has gone very wide on the wing. Djokic is there as well. They're short-handed, remember, Montenegro. Here comes Popovic. The shot's on. They've scored! 1.5 minutes to go. Katarina Bulatovic, goal number 5. Team timeout, France. A 3-0 turnaround.
Un de plus pendant 550 secondes. On est patient, on est dangereux. D'accord?
There it is. Djokic came in at the back, held the defense back. And Katarina Bulatovic with the fifth goal.
On met deux pivots. Alex, t'es dangereux.
Alisson slams the ball away, and Barjaktarovic, who's had such a role to play here.
Et tu peux y aller tranchant. Attends, non, il ne joue pas avec la chasuble pour l'instant. Allez, on marque.
Well, tension is palpable in the arena. France is scoring now down to 48%. Just when it's crucial, Miljanic can't look anymore. The suspended player, neither can the fans. France now have 1.5 minutes, but they have 50 seconds with the extra player. They have to make this count. A mistake here, and this quarterfinal could slip away from them. Lacabert. Who's going to have the nerves to take the shot? It's saved, but a penalty's been given. Pino is fouled, but haven't scored it yet. Missed the last one. Lacrabert passed it. There was a gap there, and you could see how Knežević was already in the area and basically threw herself into Pino. Lacrabert steps up again. Brave. After missing one. No mistake this time. It's all square again. And we're inside the last minute. If it stays like this, there will be 2x5 minutes extra time. Montenegro in an enviable position, at least that they have possession. Just need to make this a late goal and shut out France. 30 seconds. Miminović, team timeout, Montenegro. They're back at full strength. What tension. What incredible tension in this game. France is shooting in the first half. 59% success rate. It's dropped right down. It's below 50%. Two missed penalties by France. Three in the game by Montenegro. Popović, Bulatović and Knežević. And oh, how these are coming back to haunt them now. Move being called. Well, they're going to have to be very quick about hitting back. See, the French assistant coach is holding a red bib. This is for a player if they want to take out the goalkeeper and put on an extra court player. No one's wearing it yet. It's been put away. 26 seconds to go. Here we go then. Montenegro score, and that could well be it. Semi-final place for them. France are defending deep, keeping an eye on Popović. Tervel. Katarina Bulatović. The ball is intercepted. They're up again. Knežević saved, and a penalty's been given. 2 seconds to go. The clock has run out. Eglon is down injured. She's taken a blow. But the penalty has been given. There was a fumble. Tervel had a hand on the ball, but pushed off it by Popović. Miminović then fouled as the ball came out. But Eglon, I think she's got a dead leg. She's still down, both are down. And Krumholz cannot believe it. Adds his cheers on. And she is in pain, in great, great pain, Eglon, by all accounts. She gets up. And she's in tears. They're going to have to carry her off, but the Montenegrin fans are on their feet. Sad sight of Eglon being taken to the side. And it looks like Katarina Bulatović is going to volunteer to take the penalty that could put Montenegro into the semi-finals. If she misses, it's extra time. Eglon comes forward. She scores, and Montenegro have done it. They have beaten France 23-22. It will not be Popović's last game here. They run down to the goalkeeper, Barjaktarović, who with her 11 saves has been instrumental in this, and Leno can't believe it. France are out. The players are down all over the pitch, the French. and Leno almost in tears, and it's all ended for France. And Montenegro, we knew they were a threat. They were podium material, and they have done it with a penalty in the last second. France, leading by two in the latter stages, couldn't hold the lead. Tervel so close to getting a hand on the ball, there she is. They would have stolen it back for France. And instead, somehow, she lost control of it. And Montenegro have scored off a penalty. Katarina Bulatovic and Popovic, six apiece, were top scorers in the game for Montenegro. And the French are left to reflect on what might have been. Popovic in tears. This her final tournament before she retires from professional handball. And it's the benefit of having a team drawn entirely almost from one club. Popovic, who was a bit quiet in the second half, but was still working away. Signati and others are in tears. They had it in their grasp, the French. Both teams defended really hard, but in the end, Montenegro beat them again. They beat them in the Olympic qualifier, and they beat them now in the Olympics as well. It will take time for the French to come to terms with this, but all congratulations must go to Montenegro. This game went backwards and forwards through this half. It's all the worse for Tervel because she had a hand on that rebound ball. Kanto is still consoling poor old Dembele. And so we have our semi-finalists. Here it was. She lifted the right leg, and Katarina Bulatovic taunts the goalkeeper afterwards as she puts the ball down there before turning to celebrate with the team. Well, absolute drama here in London. France are out. Here it is again, that penalty. It took a cool nerve from a player who missed the penalty earlier. And Baryaktarovic coming to terms with it. She couldn't look. That was when the penalty was being taken. And Adzic looked the other way as well and waited for the reaction of his other coaching staff to tell him, yes, she scored. And that's the reaction on the other bench. So Krumholz, it's all over. France are going home. Well, an incredible, incredible game. The drama all the way through, and in the end, Montenegro have beaten France 23-22 here in the Copper Box Arena. Well, for France, four goals for Signate simply weren't enough. The scoring fairly well spread, but the goalkeeper made 12 saves, Amandine Leno. She played a brilliant second half, but Baryaktarovic outshining her with critical saves right at the end when France could have gone three in front. Dembele, who had a chance there as well, parried away on the wing. And the team, drawn almost entirely from the Champions League winners Budućnost, have put themselves into the last four and within touching distance of a medal. Well, an incredible game. The crowd, some of them still waiting on the far side and applauding as the players come off. Their first Olympic game under their own flag, Montenegro, and they've gone through to the semi-finals against the experienced French side, who were runners-up at the last World Championships. Miljanic there, the number two, who was in tears when she got sent off. And here are the statistics in the end, very closely matched in terms of shooting averages, 49% to France, 55 for Montenegro for the goals. Fast break, three for France, 15 turnovers for France, 13 for Montenegro. They played it so quick, but three missed penalties for the Montenegrins, two for the French. Could have proved costly in the end. Montenegro did win the match, ironically, on a penalty. Incredible. What a finale. Well, the crowd have been brilliant here at the Copper Box. Those who are seeing this for the first time, what a treat they've had here. It has been all that we wanted from a game here. And so here's confirmation of the quarterfinal lineup, Norway will play South Korea, while Spain will play Montenegro. Winners against France here in this quarterfinal. Those matches will be played in 2 days' time, the final on Saturday. Tomorrow it will be men's quarterfinal day. Well, the crowd's drifting away here. The quarterfinals over, semi-final lineup is known. It all started with both teams shadowing each other. It was level, each team taking turns at moving into the lead. Defenses were in prominence here, and neither goalkeepers particularly shone early on. But it was still too close to call, and by the halftime break, it was 13-all. As both coaches got well worked up, some fantastic long-range passes by Linot, the goalkeeper for France, to set up her team. Dembele in particular on the end, but it was tension all the way through to the end. Missed penalties all round, three of them for Montenegro, two for France. This one of them that could have potentially secured it for France. Barjaktarović, brilliant. And in the end, this penalty by Katarina Bulatović started the celebrations for Montenegro. They are through to the semi-finals. Popović and her teammates had done it, and the French left to reflect on what might have been. The passion took them through. If they can replicate that in the semi-final, who knows where this might go. Demidovic celebrates. And there we have it. The Olympic debutants are through. Barjaktarović played such an important role in this game. As her teammates come down to thank her for her huge contribution. Amazing scenes of celebration here in the Copper Box. That's it then. We know the semi-finalists. Hope you've enjoyed the game. Thanks again for watching. And until next time, from me, Paul Bray, goodbye.